Hello everyone, my name is Shai Sharon and I'm a surgeon scientist, and in today's video we're going to discuss Anki cards. The video will be divided into three sections. In the first section I'm going to describe my experience with Anki cards, both as a student and as a teacher. In the second section we're going to dive deeper into the science behind using the Anki cards, and in the third section we're going to describe how to use Anki cards and how to install it on your system. So, without further ado, let's get to it. My guide to Anki cards: active recall and spaced repetitions. Let's start by describing my experience. Over the years, I experimented with various studying methods, both as a student and as a teacher. And over my 20 years of training, which included being a student, medical student, and dental student, and also a resident and a fellow, I experimented with many systems of studying. And as a teacher for the last 25 years, I guided my students through their studying journey. And the single most important thing I've learned over the years, that active learning is the most effective study method by far. And we'll go deep into what is active learning in a bit. Having said that, and even with all my background, both as a student and as a teacher, I only started using Anki cards about 3 years ago. Definitely too late. If I would have done it earlier, I can guarantee you that I would have known much more today. I would have much better grades, and I would do all that in a fraction of the time that I did over the years. This is my experience, and in order for us to understand why using Anki cards, let's first understand the science behind it. The two pillars that form the basis for Anki cards or any other flashcards methods are active recall and spaced repetitions. Let's start with active recall. Active recall is the process your mind undergoes when trying to remember the answer. It means that your brain works in order to remember. Whenever you make your brain actively work, you are inducing neurons, which are the cells within your brain. You induce your neurons to work simultaneously, meaning if two neurons are starting to work together, the stronger the connection becomes between them. And this is the basis of any kind of learning. In contrast, when you engage in passive ways of studying, such as preparing summaries or reading summaries or highlighting passages, these are all passive way of learning. And passive way of learning will never be as effective as active recall. So this is the difference between active and passive learning. And what about spaced repetitions? What is it exactly? So remember the two neurons, the two that work together, and then the connection between them becomes stronger. So it's not enough to make them work together. You want to make these two neurons work together over and over again. So how do spaced repetitions actually work? Let's say you answered a question on a flashcard and then you waited 10 minutes and then you saw the question again and answered it again. After 30 minutes, you see the question again and answer it again. So on day one, you answered the question 3 times. A day passes and then you stumble on this question again on day 2 and you answer it once. And then you see this question only 3 days afterwards on day 5. And then you answer it once. Then you see it a week later, answer it 2 weeks later, and answer it 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, and so on. And what happens if you get the answer wrong? Then you make the spaces between repetitions much smaller. So if you got it wrong, then you'll see the question after 1 day, and then you're going to see it after 1 week and not 2 weeks. And then you're going to see it after 3 weeks and not 1 month. And then you're going to see it after 5 weeks, 2 months, and etc. So in this way, your neurons work together in a spaced manner. And as long as you stumble upon this question again and again, the stronger the connection becomes between these two neurons. So this is the principle of spaced repetitions. At this point, you might be wondering, how can I know how long to wait before I revisit a subject? You told me I can see it after 1 day, and then after day two, and day five. I have hundreds of questions that I need to see over and over again. How can I keep track? Thanks to Anki, the Anki Cards system, you don't need to worry about that at all. This app will take care of everything for you. Anki was built on the foundations of active recall and spaced repetitions. So every time you use Anki, you're studying in the most efficient and productive way possible. Okay, so this is the science behind the Anki cards with active recall and spaced repetition as the pillars of the Anki card system. So let's demonstrate how Anki works. You can see the screen of my phone here, and the app is open. You can see the decks. Right now we're going to go into the first deck, which is called Anki Demonstration. We have 4 cards to study there. So we're going to click it, and then we're going to see the first question. The average heart rate of an adult is, I think, is 60 to 80. I'll click the screen and I'll see the answer. So I knew it well. So I'm clicking the green good button. I knew it well. On to the next question. The normal systolic blood pressure is below, it's 120. I'm going to click the screen. Yeah, I knew it and I know it really well. So I'm going to press the blue button, which was easy for me. The normal diastolic blood pressure is below, I'm not sure about that. I'll click the screen, 80. So I didn't know that that well. So I'm going to click the red button here. The normal respiratory rate is between, I'm not sure. So yeah, I'm going to click the red button here as well because I didn't know these questions very well. So right now I'm done with my 4 cards. I'm going to wait a few minutes and then I can open the app again on my phone. So a few minutes have passed. I'm going to open the app on my phone. And I will see again the question that I didn't know that well, the normal diastolic blood pressure. So now I know it's below 80. I'm going to click the screen. Yes, so I'm clicking green, so I knew it well now. On to the next question, normal respiratory rate. Okay, it's between 12 and 16. I know it now. So I'm going to click the screen. Yeah, it's 12 and 16. I'm going to press the green button. Okay, so I saw only the questions that I didn't know that well, and I saw them only after a few minutes after studying them for the first time. We'll wait a bit more and then we'll open the app again on the phone. This time we're going to see the average heart rate of an adult. I knew it well, 60 to 80. I see it again. And right now the green button, notice that it says 1 day. Next time we'll see this question in 1 day. Normal diastolic blood pressure is below 80. Now I know it. So I'm going to click the green. So again, I'm going to see it in 1 day. Normal respiratory rate, so it's 12 and 16. Now I know it, and I'm going to press the blue. I know it really well, so I press the blue button. And I'm done for today with studying my 4 cards. Of course, in real life, you're going to study a lot more cards than that, and not just these 4. Suppose I want to study ahead. I have more time today to study more cards, and I know that tomorrow I won't have a lot of time to study. This is the beauty of Anki. You can go. And although I'm done with the question, I can click the custom study feature here. And once I click it, you can see that I can choose the option of review ahead. I'm going to click it and I'm going to review 1 day ahead. I'm going to see the questions meant to appear only tomorrow. Average heart rate as an adult is 60 to 80. I'm going to click it. Yep, I got it right. So I'm going to press the green button. The normal diastolic blood pressure, now we know it's below 80. So I press it and now I'm done with this deck. Of course, in this case, I changed the schedule. I changed the space repetition. I was meant to see these questions only tomorrow. But what I'm showing you right here, that Anki also gives you some flexibility. and changing the way you study on the go, which is great when you study a lot of material at once. So next, let's see how to install Anki. You can install Anki on your computer, and on your computer, this is where you're going to prepare Anki cards. So you navigate to Anki Web and you can download Anki free onto your computer. In order to install it on your tablet or on your phone, you can go to the App Store in case you're using Apple devices, or you can go to the Google Play Store. Please note that on the App Store, this app will cost you $25. And on Android, there is the app which is called AnkiDroid Flashcards, which is a free app and you can use it with your flashcards. So this is how you install Anki on your computer and on your devices. This is the opening screen of the Anki app on my computer, and I want to add a new card. I'm going to navigate online. I'm going to copy this heart rate pulse between 60 and 100. So I click copy and I paste it here. And now the part that I want to close is this part. So I'm marking it and add. Now I see the new card here in my Anki demonstration deck. When I go into this deck and hit study now, I see the question, heart rate, pulse, and the area of the sentence that I wanted to close is now hidden. Once I press the space, I can see the answer and I can choose, as I showed you before, whether it was hard, good, easy, or I want to see it again in 10 minutes, pretty similar to what we see on our phone. This question will be synchronized to all of my devices that have the Anki app installed on them. So this is how you prepare your own Anki cards. The sequence is copy-paste a sentence that you took from somewhere. You highlight a section that you want to close and then hit Ctrl-Shift-C or Command-Shift-C on a Mac, click Done, and that's it. It takes 5 seconds to prepare a card, and the app will take care of the active recall and the space repetitions for you. All you need to do is just study. Everything is synced seamlessly between your devices. The data is saved on your devices. So except for synchronizing, you can be offline and still continue to study. Suppose you're on an airplane or just without internet access, you can continue studying, which is very important. There is no data limit on what you store on the Anki servers. And you don't need to worry about losing your data. And this is how it's done. Okay, pretty simple. Before we wrap up, I want to explain why I prepare my own Anki cards and why I prefer to do it this way. Reason number one, every person has a different way of thinking and a different pre-existing knowledge and different goals for the studying. So if someone else prepare the cards and I use them, they will leave out information that I need to study and they will include information I already know. So I will waste time on reviewing cards on subjects I already know and I won't learn the facts that I actually need to learn. So this is reason number one. Reason number two for preparing my own cards is that I prefer to structure my card in a certain way instead of preparing 3 different cards. For example, one card for heart rate, one card for respiratory rate, and one card for the blood pressure. I prefer to put them all in the same card. So I have 3 closed parts on the same card. I rather study it this way. So I have less cards to study, but other people will prefer it otherwise. So this is the second reason. And the last reason is to save time. It might seem counterintuitive because when you download someone else's cards, the time that you invest in preparing cards is 0. Okay, you actually downloaded it. But in the process of preparing my own card, it is easier for me to study my own card in the certain way that I put the words in. So I found that it takes me less time to study the cards that I prepared. So at the end, the total time that I invest in studying is much less whenever I prepared my own cards. So these are my 3 reasons for preparing my own Anki cards. Before I conclude, let's take my studying for the USMLE exam as an example. The USMLE has three steps, step one, step two, and step three. Step two and step three are pretty similar in what they test you on. And between the time I took step two and the time I took step three, I had 10 months in between. But when I started to study for step three, I actually looked on material that I reviewed for the last time 6 months ago. I still remembered most of what I learned. And this is just because I used active learning and spaced repetitions with Anki. And I'm not referring to seeing a question again and say, that sounds familiar. Let's see what the answer is. I knew about 70% of the questions 6 months after studying them, 6 to 10 months after studying them for the last time. And this is the first time in my life that I was able to remember something, although I didn't see it for that long of a period of time. And I didn't have the same experience whenever I learned using different systems. So this is the example, and this is why I highly recommend you give Anki cards a try and utilize the active recall and spaced repetition methodology in order to study better and retain the information for longer periods of time. This is pretty much it. This app has many cool add-ons. You can also put in images and close different part or hide different part of the images. And this is great for anatomy or any other subject that you want to hide certain parts of the images. So you have a lot of add-ons you can add on your Anki app. There are many videos out there that show you how to do it. In this video, I wanted to explain my approach, so I didn't go into that. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.